You're joining us for another episode of College Talks brought to you by MyBookHeart.com.
This series brings together students, parents, and professionals sharing their voices on a variety of college topics.
It's all about students finding the information they need for a successful college experience. Welcome to College Talks with your hosts, Hannah
and Carrie.
Our topic for today is admissions. For this episode, we have our newest guest, Elizabeth.
Hi, Elizabeth. Welcome to our show. Why don't you introduce yourself and tell us a little bit about your educational background?
Hi, I'm Elizabeth. I am a rising senior in high school, and I go to a private school in New London, Connecticut, and I'm currently in the midst of the college process and applying to colleges.
What schools do you plan on attending?
It's kind of hard to say right now. I do have a couple of first choices, but that's still a little bit up in the air, and I won't really know until fall.
What schools do you plan on applying to?
So I have a list of about 12 schools, and the list is pretty definite, but it might change a little bit in the near future. So far, like, I've looked at applying to Connecticut College, UConn, Wesleyan, Dickinson, which is in Pennsylvania, just to name a few.
When do you plan to apply to these schools?
So there are different deadlines for applying to these schools. So I'm planning on applying early decision to just one school because it's binding, and then applying early action, which is around in November. Early action isn't binding, so if I get into the school, I don't have to go. So, and then regular decision is in January, and I'll be applying to a couple schools that way. So basically November and January, I'll be applying.
So you said that there's deadlines for the schools that you're applying to. It sounds like the latest deadline that you have is January. Is that correct?
Yes.
Did you take the SAT or ACT? And are you finding that these tests are required at the schools that you're applying to?
So with COVID-19, everything has just kind of been pretty drastically changed. When I went into this process in March, I was planning on taking the SAT or ACT and submitting those scores to all of my colleges because most of them required the standardized testing at that time. But because of COVID-19, all of my schools but one have gone test optional. So that is something that I'm seriously considering, just skipping out on testing this year.
So from what I've read, a common app is a standard application that's filled in for multiple colleges. Are you using that common app or do they have their own application?
So most of the colleges, actually all of them that I'm applying to except for one, are on the Common App, which makes it really easy because I only have to fill it out once. Just one school that I'm applying to has their own application on their website. So for the most part, I'm using the Common App.
What is the average GPA of students that are accepted?
It really depends on the school, but most of the schools that I'm looking at, you have to have at least a 3.7.
Do the schools you're applying to consider interviews with the application process? And if they do, how do the interviews work now that there is the COVID-19 pandemic?
For different colleges, it's different. For a lot of prestigious colleges, like Ivy Leagues, they'll tell you that they don't really look at your interview in the application process. So in that case, the interview would be mainly informational. It would be less about interviewing you and getting to know you, even though that would happen, but it would be mostly just giving the student information about the college. Other schools do look at the interview, and in my opinion, I think it's a really important aspect of the application because it gives you the opportunity to really talk about yourself and get to know these colleges and for them to know you a little better than reading about you on paper.
That's a really good point you just made. Are the colleges that you're applying to require essays? And if they do, have you already picked your topic or do they supply one for you?
You have a choice for most of the colleges. They have prompts that you can answer, but then they also have, pretty much all of them have this other prompt that says, just write about something that's important to you or like give us insight into your life. And that's pretty much the prompt that I'm going to do because that's something that I can submit to all colleges. And I have started writing my essay. So yeah, I'm not done yet, but I am planning on going that route.
Have you taken any college tours? What schools did you tour? And do you have any tips for students who are looking to start touring colleges?
I did tour UConn and Wesleyan. I haven't toured Dickinson or any of my colleges in other states right now, basically because of COVID-19. But also because of COVID-19, it has made it a little easier to interview. because you don't have to actually drive to the school. They're doing virtual everything. So virtual interviews, virtual tours, and virtual information sessions. So that makes it a lot easier. And that is something that I am currently doing during the summer.
Did you find that taking a virtual tour was informative as the tours that you did in person?
Yes, I did. The only down part about it was that you don't really get a sense of the area that the college is in. So for a couple of my colleges, I'm looking at applying. They're actually in Washington, D.C. And well, the virtual tour is very helpful because you get to see the campus. You don't really get to see the area that surrounds the campus. So you don't get to see the neighborhood or Washington, D.C., the entire city, and you don't really get a very good feel for that. So that's kind of something that's been a little difficult for me.
On your tours, what did you learn and what was your first impression?
I know it sounds a little cheesy, but when you see a college, you just kind of know that you fit there. For me, I'm looking for a campus that is green and suburban, but that I have access to a city. So just being on the campus and seeing the dorms and also getting to meet like students and admissions officers, sometimes each college will give you a certain vibe about that college. And sometimes, you know, being on the campus and meeting those people, you just kind of know that the school's a good fit for you.
Did college reps come to your high school to talk to you?
Yes. So every year my school has a college fair in October, and I'm not sure if that's going to be happening this year because of COVID-19, but we have over 100 colleges that come to my school and that I get to talk to the actual admissions representatives that would be reading my application and potentially admitting me into the school. So that has been really helpful.
Did you pick your colleges from the college fair?
Yeah. So some of them I learned by them coming to my school. Others are just schools that I've heard about or that my college counselor has recommended for me. Sometimes, you know, like a school that my parent went to as well.
Why did you decide to apply to these colleges? Or do you already have your major picked? Were there other deciding factors?
I'm looking to go to law school after my undergraduate years. So for me, it's really important that I go to an undergraduate school that'll set me up really well for law school and help me to get into a good law school. But also too, I am looking at schools that have their own law schools that I could potentially go to after my undergraduate years at that school. So for me, that's an important aspect of looking at. And then also the average wage that someone makes coming from that college and the kind of success that they have is also important.
Do you know anyone who has attended any of the schools that you're applying to?
Yes, I do. I have a lot of friends and peers that have graduated from my high school and that have gone to these schools. And that is kind of how I found out about them.
Let's get personal. What is your GPA?
My GPA, I'm not really sure about because my school hasn't finalized it yet, but it's around a 3.8.
Wow, that's great, Elizabeth. That's fantastic.
Thank you.
What are you most looking forward to in attending college?
I'm really just looking forward to being able to study something that I'm interested in, because in high school, like, you have to take a math, a science, history, English. In college, I'm looking forward to just prioritizing and putting a main focus on what I'm interested in learning and just being in that kind of classroom every day.
Are you planning on joining any sororities or clubs when you're at college?
So I don't know about sororities, but I definitely am planning on maybe writing for their newspaper because I love writing and I love English. I love that class. So then also too, I'm a dancer, so I'll probably be involved in their dance team.
Do you plan to live on campus?
Yes, I do. Mainly because most of my schools that I'm looking at are 5 hours away, or they're a decent distance away. So yes, I will be.
Are you nervous about being accepted into college?
I actually am very nervous, especially because of COVID-19. If I choose to go the test optional route and don't submit my scores, it is a little harder to get into these schools. And honestly, there's no way of knowing if you'll get in or not. Like, you could look at the statistics of like the GPAs and the test scores of students that have gotten into these schools, but there really is no way of knowing.
What kind of extracurricular activities have you done in high school that are going to help your application or getting into college?
One huge extracurricular for me that I've really taken all the way and explored every aspect of is dance. Dance outside of school and inside of school, and it's just a huge part of my life. But I'm also involved in like my school newspaper, my school literary journal, so I'll be publishing a couple of my pieces, and my service committee as well. So just going out in the community where my school is and helping others and doing community service.
Have you applied to any scholarships yet?
No, but I am definitely planning on it.
Is there anything else that you'd like to share about your admissions process or getting into college that you would think that is helpful to other students?
I would just say go in with a positive attitude and know that like your list of colleges will change. But also I think it's really important to kind of get ahead in the process. Right now it's July and I already have my list of colleges that I know I'm pretty much going to apply to, and I feel confident in them and I have that aspect of the process over. And most of my classmates, unfortunately, are still trying to tour colleges and figure out their list and where they want to apply. And to me, I think it's important to just be organized and get ahead so that you're not stressed out even more than you already are.
Now that you've given some helpful advice to other students, can you also share some of your concerns that you have starting college?
I am definitely concerned about being away from home because I am a homebody, and most of the schools I'm looking at, like I've said, are like 5-hour drive. I won't be able to come home on the weekends. But also too, I think that's good for me because it helps me grow my independence and not rely on my parents so much, even though I really am going to miss my family because I'm very close with them. I'm a little concerned about that aspect, but I am really excited to be able to live somewhere else other than my small town in Connecticut and be able to meet new people and just kind of start over, I guess.
Lastly, are your parents helping you with the college application process, or are you doing it all on your own?
It's really important for students and parents to kind of set boundaries in this process and work together because it is really stressful. And so I've kind of worked that out with my parents where they took care of the financial aid process and they're taking care of, but then also like we're going to tours and information sessions together, and we're even bringing my little sisters along so that they can kind of get insight into what it's going to look like in 2 years when they're applying to school. So yeah, I have had some help from my parents and of course their support, but I am trying to do a good amount of it on my own.
Thank you, Elizabeth, for coming on our show and offering all this valuable insight on the college admissions process. We'd love hearing a student's perspective on how to apply to college. We are all about students helping students. We hope you will join us again on another episode.
Thank you for having me.
And we will be waiting impatiently to hear what college you will be attending. Thanks, Elizabeth. Here's to another successful episode of College Talks.
Please follow us at My Book Cart on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter to stay up to date on any new episodes.